So now when I go back to my hand tool, which is what we're going to do, I could actually move that around as one shape. I can use two fingers to zoom it in and out, and that's what I'm doing. I'm just using two fingers and kind of zooming in and out, just like that. So again, one finger, move it around, two fingers, kind of zoom, twist, bring in and out. Now, as you can see, I have a, well, you probably actually can't see it. I have a red line. It's helping me, there's a few features with the hand tool. So let's click on those. So if you look at the hand tool on the left side, there's something called ellipses there, right? And so that kind of tells you if you tap it again, you're going to have more options. So I'm going to tap it again, and it brings up these options, right? So let me tell you what each of these things do. The snap to objects, right? What those do is they help you essentially align images with the center of something. Or what it does is it helps you put them on the edge of something. So it kind of brings up these red lines and helps you kind of bring them in and snap it there. So you don't have to use that. You can. It's something I like as well. The next thing is, if I bring it up again, is touch and hold. And touch and hold just means you can access the inspector by just touching and wait for it, hold, right? And so that it came up. And we're going to get into the inspector later. I just want you to see that there's these things. So if you don't want that, if you keep accidentally doing it, you can turn it off super easily as well. All right. So let's take a look at the next option, and that's drag and drop. And drag and drop allows you to insert files from other apps using the drag and drop multitasking function that's in the operating system, in the iOS operating system. I'll show you how to do that a little bit later. And then the last one is zoom and pan. So what zoom and pan does would essentially allow you to, when you're not on a shape, basically zoom in and out. It could be faster, but it could also kind of get in the way. So for example, with it on, I could zoom in and out of the entire thing and I'm not clicking on the shape, right? This is just a zoom. But then if I turn it off, see how I'm off the shape and it's not doing that? It's just a way to kind of zoom in and out in a kind of a fast way. I actually really like it, so I'm gonna leave that on. All right, so that is the hand tool, right? So say I want to, let's kind of create a new one there, all right? So let's say we're gonna go back to, let's go back here. All right, so here I have, I'm gonna kind of get rid of some stuff for now. I'll explain these tools later. All right, so, but I want to focus on what we've known so far, which is the hand tool and the pen tool, right? So I have this, I'm starting, right? And so say I want my students to do a proof and then talk about it, which is why Split Everything is great, because you can talk about what you're doing. So I'm going to use my finger, just one finger, and I'm going to just move it over. And actually, I think it's a little big, so I'm going to use two fingers and pinch in. All right, I want to have that right there. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a T-chart, but what I want to have is a ruler to make sure my lines are straight. And so I'm going to use my pen right above the ruler, right? Because if I just touch the ruler, it'll just move the ruler. Perfect. All right. Now I'm going to use two fingers and twist this ruler. All right. And then line that up where I want to be. Again, I'm going to be just off of the ruler, not on the ruler, because if I'm on the ruler, I'm trying to use the ruler. All right. Now I'm going to go back to the pen, get rid of the ruler. All right. So now I could be doing some sort of a proof, right? So I can start my T-chart. You know, I could, you know, helps if you don't hit the home button. All right. So I'm going to say given, right? And then so and so. I'm not going to do a proof here. So, but this could be one example. And then what you could do is you could have students then record their thoughts and kind of talk through the entire process, and they can have both their image that they drew as well as their proofs all on the screen. So that's one example we could use.